Hello, my name is Miroslav. I work as a software engineer at STMicroelectronics. In this video, I would like to present you our Unicleo-GUI application. The objective of this application is to demonstrate functionality of ST sensors and algorithms, which we provide in the X-NUCLEO-IKS01 and X-NUCLEO-IKS XT1 software packages. To be able to test this solution, you will need a hardware. You can use Nucleo board, one of these which is displayed in the list, plus motion MEMS and environmental sensor expansion board. You can also use a sensor which is soldered on DIL24 adapter. The sensors in the DIL24 adapter are supported only by the X-NUCLEO-IKS XT1 package. You can download the Unicleo-GUI from the st.com. After you download the application, you can execute the installer. The installation is very simple. You just need to accept the license agreement, select the location of the application, and optionally you can install a virtual COM port driver, which is needed to use the application. And that's it. Now you are ready to use the Unicleo-GUI. The Unicleo-GUI looks like this. It is divided into three sections. The first one is the horizontal toolbar. The first part of the horizontal toolbar is selection of the COM port where your Nucleo board is connected. When I connect the board, it will automatically recognize that the board is programmed with a firmware which is compatible with the Unicleo-GUI. So it will offer me only the port with the proper Nucleo boards. The next section is buttons, which allows you to connect and disconnect the board. So I can do it. And then there are buttons to start and stop data capturing, the button which open the settings, and of course the button which close the application. On the left side, there is a vertical toolbar, which content is automatically adjusted to the firmware which is programmed to the Nucleo board. So right now I have a simple Datalog firmware in the Nucleo board, so it offers me to see the data coming from the motion and environmental sensors and also save the data to the file. The main section of the application uses the tabs where you can find several information. The first one is the info tab, where you can find the version of the Unicleo, version of the firmware which is programmed into the Nucleo board, a version of the library if it's used, and the expansion board which is compatible with the firmware. Next up is a firmware management tab which you can use to program the Nucleo board. You have to place your firmware into proper directory. If you do so, then you can directly program your Nucleo board using this firmware management tab by simple double-clicking on the firmware which you want to use. Next up is called user messages, where you can see all the messages coming from the Nucleo board to the application. And last tab is also adjusted to the firmware which is used. Right now it allows me to adjust the parameters of the sensors connected to the Nucleo board. Right now I have programmed the Nucleo board with the Datalog firmware, so we can have a look what it allows us to do. So we can enable or disable each sensor. Right now I have the motion and environmental sensor expansion board connected, so we can enable accelerometer, gyroscope, magnetometer, and the pressure sensor, humidity, or the temperature sensor. And we can also adjust the full scale if the sensor has this capability. And we can also set the ODR, which means output data rate of each sensor. If your sensor is correctly configured, you can press start and the firmware will start to send the data to the application. We can display the data in charts. There is a dedicated chart for the motion sensors, which is accelerometer, gyroscope, and magnetometer. And second chart for the environmental sensors, which is temperature, humidity, and pressure sensor. You can enable or disable autoscale functionality of each chart. You can also do a zoom in the time domain, and you can use a cursor to read the data at the selected time. There is one more possibility for each sensor. You can read or write to any sensor register. You just need to write the address of the register and press the get or set button. Right now I will try to read UMI register of the accelerometer LSM6DSL, so I will write the address, which is 0F. Press the get button and the application reads the register. The content is 6A, which is correct. Unicleo-GUI allows to demonstrate functionality not only of sensors but also of motion libraries, which we offer in X-Cube MEMS 1 package. Right now we offer 19 libraries which can be used for the sensor calibration, motion tracking, and activity recognition for mobile or wrist-worn devices. As an example, we can try to demonstrate functionality of sensor fusion algorithm. So I will program the Nucleo board with the Datalog Fusion firmware. I will double-click on it. And right now the program is downloaded to the Nucleo board. After that, the Unicleo GUI will wait for the response of the board. And then it should automatically connect to the board. So the board is now ready. I can press start to execute the sensor fusion algorithm. The sensor fusion algorithm captures the data from all three motion MEMS sensors and calculates the position of the device in 3D space. The output of this algorithm are quaternions, Euler angles, gravity vector, linear acceleration, and heading. You can display the position of the board as a 3D model of the teapot on your screen. Thank you for watching this video. For more information, please visit st.com.